Sunny day, so I'm going to have to do this in English. That's fine, yeah, okay, so I'll take a couple of notes on this. This sort of thing, what the proposal would be is for, particularly here and here. Slide two and three. Slide two. Yeah, okay, and here and the next one as well. Next one. Yeah, okay, these. These slides, you can base some of this on the introduction, right? So the ideas that you got in the introduction will fill out these slides, right? So you've already collected the content, it's just organizing it differently for this type of presentation, right? So you don't have to invent anything, you've already got it, you've already gone through it in your minds. So what I want to look at really is some problems I've had. Most of the students in here are pretty good so far. You know, I've got two or three projects this morning, project proposals, which are basically finished, right? So I'm quite happy. But we still got some problems with some other groups, particularly students who aren't here. And that's why I've got him to film it, right? So that we can put this up online later. One of the major problems is going from draft one to draft two. Right? Now, draft one was hard work. I know that. You know, so you're doing the writing, you're collecting the content, and then you've got to do it in English, which you haven't done for years, and you know, you've forgotten everything. Most of the problems, as I keep saying, come from Mathion 1, Mathion 2, you know, the grammar you learned there, and then forgot immediately, because you never use it. So what happens, unfortunately, with some students, when you go from draft one to draft two, it's not an evolution. Some students just scrap everything in draft one and start again, which is really destroying all the work that they've done. That's just no. I would avoid that. And bringing in lots of stuff from the internet, which some students have done, is not the way to write. Okay? What you're doing with the proposals, this is your ideas. You know, your approach to your project. As one of those slides said before, as you start the writing process, you begin to discover things that you don't know and things that you need, right? So you're inventing content as you are doing the writing. But then if you bring in lots of stuff from the internet, that's not you. And that's what I want students to absolutely steer clear of. You aren't experts, so you need support, right? That's where the internet comes in. It's to support your ideas, not to replace the ideas, okay? I know some students have got problems with English, actually producing sentences in English. You have to remind yourselves, right? You know, basic stuff that you learned in Mathion 1, Mathion 2 still applies today. Subject, verb, object, the prepositions, subject, verb, agreement, right? These are all basic things. You have to work through them as you're writing. But said to a group this morning that for me, if I see a piece of writing, it takes me two or three nanoseconds to identify a problem and fix it. You guys can't do that because it's not your language, and I do know that, right? But you still have to work through it slowly and carefully so that you identify the problems which you learned at Mordoon, Morsan, Morsan, and improve the writing. Any questions for me, guys? At all? Okay, let's go. Thank you.